A miracle that's going to somewhere to come and happen. Your life is undecodable. Please share about your friend. Share among your friend, God bless you. Today's going to be marvelous. Today we are talking about purpose. Just share, invite your friend, share, invite your friend. God bless you. David's in freedom. I want to pray. God bless you. Monica Mercy, God bless you, Rico. You are like a miracle that's going somewhere to go and happen. Mama J. Maris, God bless you, my God. Your destiny is undecodable. Sonny Rui, God bless you.
Amen.
Happy Lord. My small mother, God bless you. Blood is thicker than water. You are welcome. Merci, nous t'assons bien. Oh, mon coro, God bless you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Let me also play. There's one music I saw today. Because they don't know their purpose. That is why it's make hunger. Everybody's starving Nigeria today.
Some even they sing for the Sinesi house. So I said, we are new. Then go, then don't go, bring come on.
Please just share, share. The only weapon we have right now is to make sure we share so that we can be able to get to. We have to send this message far. Because they don't know their purpose. Because they don't know their purpose. Please just share, share, invite your friend. Thank you, everyone, and may the peace of the Lord be with you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Ancient of Glory, we are here once again, O Lord, to talk about the purpose why you created us. The purpose why we are made is that, O Lord, I pray. As soon as this message comes forth for the throne of grace, everywhere this message is going to go, O Lord, may you cause the divine interpretations. So as many that have a reprobate heart like Pharaoh, Father, Lord, they will free us and they will let us to achieve our dream. They will give us the grace to take it back in the mighty name of Jesus. Let this message, O Lord, heal every soul. Let this message, O Lord, as many where it's going to go, Father, Lord, let it be a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So I welcome each and every one of us today to the broadcast. Today we want to be seeing some of the objective of IAACP and some of the main purpose why we are called to lead. And there is also a sense why every individual must know their purpose in life and let everyone stand up to bring agenda into our societies. This message is coming from the throne of grace by Comrade Newton Igbenegun. God bless you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Please just don't hesitate to share and tag your friend. Don't hesitate to share and tag your friend. It's going to be a wonderful time today. And last week, we talked about something spectacular. We talked about eviction. And I was able to take out to the book of Hosea chapter 4, verse. It says, where there is no eviction, the people... The Hosea chapter 4, verse 8. It says, my people are in bondage because of what? They doesn't have knowledge. And also, where there is no vision, the people, they perish. God have given us a vision on how to rule. God have given us a vision on how to manage whatever thing he have given unto us. The thing is just that at times we intend to do so many things on our own. That's why we fail most of the time. But today we want to be talking about purpose. I know most of us before, please, I want this platform today by the grace of God to be a unique platform. Please, I beg you in the name of God. Do not insult anybody. Please, we don't want insult, just show love. We are going to try to see what we can do. God has made us a city that is set upon the hill. What we want to do right now, as many people who are not doing what is right, so that at the time they come here, they will learn and they will amend their ways in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, no insult, any comment you want to make, don't direct it to anybody. I just thank each and every one of you for stopping by, and please, don't still hesitate to share among your friends in the mighty name of Jesus. As you see, it's nothing one man can do alone. I cannot do it alone. I know most of us, we are using to give some of our brother's name that Mr. I cannot do it alone. And it is true, there is a sense in it. If really one really want to talk about reality, I want to try to see if I can share between some of my contacts. Please just a little bit patient. Well, it's our duty is to make sure we keep on doing the needful. We have to try as much as we can to do the needful. If I'm unable to do it, maybe some people have to take it like that, because I don't want anything to interrupt my message. I don't want anything to interrupt my message. So let us try as much as we can. We have to do our best. It's our duties to do our best. It seems really very difficult. Maybe as soon as we proceed further, there's special people who are going to be assigned for that, that's going to be doing all those things. Greetings from the Most High God Almighty. Today, let's quickly look at purpose. I know most of us at times when a message like this comes, it is very ridiculous for somebody to create a heading, just a purpose. But at the time we begin to say true, it's going to go on a V-shape. Before you know it, will land us to a realm where angels play mamanko. At the end of the day, those things that we have been misquoting ourselves with, those things that we are not be doing right, God will give us the grace to do it. The reason why I've channeled to be my advocacy to always coagulate with the word of God, because without God, there's nothing can be done. So if you look at the meaning of purpose, see, secularly, it means the reason for which something exists or it is done, made or used. That is to say, there is a sense why God have made you after his own image and after his likeness. In the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, there is a purpose. And today, after we might have glanced through, then we're also going to be seeing the objectives of the International Association for the Advancement of Colored People. The objective, it also stands for the purpose. Some of the things you are going to be seeing, that some of the things we are trying to eliminate from our various society. Number one, to ensure a social, political, educational, and economic equality of all children, of all citizens. To ensure a social, political, educational, and economic equality of all citizens. It's all talking about equality in education, equality in politics, equality in our social, equality in our economics. There should be equality in our education. And point number two, to achieve equality of rights and to eliminate racial prejudices among the citizens of the whole world. To eliminate what? To let there be equality of every citizen and to eliminate racial prejudices among all citizens all over the world. And to remove all barriers and racial discrimination through a democratic process. It's not going to be by fight. We have to negotiate it. Some of the aims and objectives of the International Association for the Advancement of the Colored People. We have to make sure this color, we advance it to where you have not gone before. We have to make sure that we put value upon ourselves. How are we going to achieve this goal when we does not know the purpose why we are being made a leader or the purpose why we exist? A lot of people, they exist right now, they don't live. The people that live are the people that make impact. The people that exist are the people that say, cannot degbe, we not degbe. Then number four, to seek enemies and enforcement of a federal state and a local law securing civil rights. We have to make sure we seek enactment and enforcement of a federal state and a local law securing civil rights. We want an ideal society whereby you have the right freedom of expression, whereby you have the right to your own opinion. We are the society we are living right now. We do not even have right to our own opinion. We are even being oppressed. According to this parable, if you can give me a geometrical latitude, although we won by more one again, you know, that is how worse our society is right now. There are some places you are, you cannot even breathe. Even when you blow kata, they'll use it against you. That is how far this society have gone. So what do we need to do right now? We need to try to eradicate all this thing through a democratic process and to inform the public of the adverse of a racial and ethnicity discrimination and to seek its elimination. To inform the public, to inform everyone, the adverse of racial and ethnicity, the problem that racial racism have caused and ethnicity are be able you be Yoruba, I be Benin, you be Afema, I be Esan, you be from Akoko Edo. We must have to make sure we abolish those things. Because when God was making us in the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 26, God never said anything that Esan is different, Benin is different. He said he created us in his own image and after all his likeness. So Daito said there is a sense why we must have to coexist together as a being. If you look at it today, to the mind, we blacks out towards ourselves. Even when we are coming all the way from Nigeria, we are getting ourselves to, before we get to Morocco, we are not having problem with the Arabs. The same people that was our problem was the people we belong to, the same ethnic group. You will see your Kobini will rise up against you. That time, the phone was called Aso Rock in Morocco. The person that speak Benin with like you. The person that even insulted my dad sister, thank God, he died in the sea. No, he did not die. He ran mad in Morocco. His name is Colostin. Because I prayed. He ran mad. It was even from Uronigbe. One of the people that make blood came out of my ear. Were from Uronigbe. So Uronigbe people have been betraying Uronigbe right from day one. He confessed it to me. Look at where I came from. How now come you are talking to my sister? But I couldn't do anything. Because of what I was under subjection of oppression. That is why today, a lot of people is going to be going to prison. At the time you are being caught in oppressive manner because you belong to this and the next person did not belong to this, I will take it upon myself. That is why we want eminent personality to come and share in this dream so that what we are suffer, other people that are coming, they will not suffer it. How does it function that time? I'm a good man. You are a passenger. Moroccans were never our problem. The Arab were never our problem. If you look at the majority of problems that is happening in Libya today, it is caused by the Nigerians. It is this so-called Nigerian that said our co-Nigerian to the Libyans. They are the one. So we have also come to make sure that we eliminate this ethnicity discrimination and to seek its elimination. We have to seek for its elimination. We have to eliminate it. That is why this platform has not been created to fight anybody. Rather than it have been, is a platform whereby you are going to hear the undiluted word. The way it is. Somebody were telling me, hey, guy, look at what happened. I said, I'm not going to still be an opposition. It's just that I needed a free mind where I can be able to reach out unto my people. Where I will not be lied upon. There's one woman I'm going to be thanking today. Mama Esther, God bless you. You are a God to so many people. I must have to confess this. I pray that what God has used you to do for people, that the hand that is bigger than you will also come and do it for you. Mama Esther, you live in Italy. If everybody will have it the same mind you have, by now, we will not be in this precarious position. But I just pray that some people change. If not, today would have been a different dimension. I came today to come and slaughter a lot of people. As you choose to condemn me, to do assassination of character, I will also do assassination of character. Do me, I do you, God, not the verse. But thank God, a woman personally saved a woman like her today. A woman saved a woman like a person like her. Just a woman. It's like, you know what was happening. Coming, look at it. He threw war into my mind. Then, out of the abundance of the heart, the man speaketh. I spread my feeling. Please, brother, I beg. I'm kneeling down. Could you know God interpreted the word of that woman? Mama Esther, God will bless you. God, wherever people is going to mention your name for evil, God will stand by you in Jesus' name. As point number six, to educate persons as their constitutional right and to take all lawful action to secure the exercise thereof and to take any other lawful action in furtherance of their what, of their objective. As far as a given society is concerned, you have your objective in that given society. So let go go to the medicine. So we are going to be seeing some people today who feel they are doing the right thing. But let me first of all blow our mind before we begin to say true. Proverbs chapter 22 verse 6. He said, train up a child. He said, the way it should grow. He said, after when it's old, it will not depart from it. That is some of your purpose. You don't just give birth to children and make them to become vagabond in the street. No. You have a purpose to fulfill in the life of your children. You have a purpose to fulfill as far as you are being called a member or a leader. That is why today, a lot of members, they did not know their purpose. Even when their leader is confused, they confuse along with him. Even when their leader is making mistakes, instead of them to be a watchman to their leader, they will do worse than their leader. That is why today, if some certain things fail, is not working. Know that it is not the fault of the leader. It is the fault of the bad followers. Judgeability. They want position by all means. Say the truth, and it will set you free. Clap, follow. Hey, do one like that, hey, punish her. Now God save you. Now God, you this woman, now God deliver you. Where God for come save you? Your husband for drive you for husband's house. I would have do you to that extent that your husband will chase you from your husband's house. Thank God a woman like you stood for you. Why not even stand and represent what is good? You don't want to do it. Hatred or truth. There's nothing bad about you scandalizing somebody, but learn to say the truth. Don't let everything you say about people are lies. 100% of what you said are fallacy. Look at a woman spoke a word and God interpreted that word. I did not tell, not even my brother, I did not tell him. I said, if I tell my brother, he's going to tell me stop. Don't do it, Newton. And I have to obey. At the time I violate my other brother, with Osan Igbinigun, then I violated the ancestors. That's why I did not tell him. I did not tell him. If maybe he may be watching, I did not tell him. I know he's going to say, my brother, I'm not doing. Because I just want to, everybody will be surprised. I will put your name there. I repair your name the way you choose to repair my name. All the way from California, your audio was sent to me. Who the hell is this woman? Then I have to go into explanation. You don't mean all these things. Brother, what makes you to start crying? I was not wondering. I thank God for Jesus. Let me don't let go. But you have to go and do restitution and repent. So that the God of vengeance, because God have already told me in the book of Exodus chapter 14 verse 14. He said, I will fight your fight, Newton, and you will hold your peace because I have labored. The name I was supposed to be called is not what you have called me. I have labored. The lowest time I spent on the journey was 10 days. The lowest time in all this feat of advocacy. But none of you. There are three numbers. There are three in this coven. One evangelist, one in Germany, and one in Italy. There are three in this coven. Three people in this coven. Three people in this coven. A misleader. I pray that God will open your leader's eye to see that you people are evil. Evil people. Evil people. And wherever you people might serve, but I'm leaving you for God. If all allegations levied against me is true, or can work on Saloba, but I've already promised God and I promised this woman, please, what you have said, I just pray that God, and God is controlling me right now. It would have been very crazy. I would have done one, the one in Italy. I'll do one for head. Then the one in Germany, you walk by your own. Then I will bring the so-called evangelist who could not even know where John 3 is still written in the Bible. May we hear me a fake prophecy. Humphrey, evangelist Humphrey, walk by your swing here because you are a man. And anytime you have locked that, I know they tally. I would have drawn you out, you will come beat me. Humphrey, now they talk, so that idiot in Italy. I will respect other women. The other women, I will leave them to their faith. I know we mentioned their name. Evangelist Humphrey, fake pastor, fake evangelist. God has saved you guys, but it does not mean that I'm not going to just talk about them. You see people are doing what you cannot do. Instead of you to applaud for them and give them encouragement. You said you saw it before. You were never sharing it. And the platform we are given to you offering. You couldn't even quote John 3:16. You were removed. But I came. None of you could see the work. None of you. But if people that are watching right now, why is it that the problem Nigeria has is that Nigeria always check motive. Nigeria always check action. They doesn't check motive. What God looks at, as far as this life is concerned, God does not check your action. He check your motive. What is the motive behind what this guy is doing? What is the motive? Nobody wants to confirm the motive. You check the action. You check the action. That's why I come here to come and... Who want to come and learn? Even my enemy can come here. I will see you. I will still teach you. Let us stop checking action. Check the motive behind it. A man is beating his son. What is the motive? You are seeing the action that a man or madam will not ever not go here. What has that son done? Maybe the man now is trying. He have read the book of Proverbs 22 verses that train up a child. How can a, for example, I want to give a vivid explanation. A child of 9 years old will go and be watching porno film. You expect his father not to beat him. He will beat him. You always to go, instead of you calling that father a bad father, then what you now do, you go there and ask, why are you beating your son? Then if your father likes you, that you are not a tatafo, just like these two witches, Fime and that Humphrey, Evangelist Humphrey, then he might explain to you that look at the motive behind why I'm beating my son. I was judged by action. Nobody judged me by motive. That is why on a meya me once or what. And that is why they say tire no ye kiva no road out. You will keep on being my back. Instead of you to learn, if not for God, if not for BK, okay, let me try and make sacrifice to my people. What will even make me to sleep the same room with you? Nothing to make me to sleep. I'm not saying you want. Okay, I'm an amant. I'm not insane. I've never wanted to be diagnosed. That have a colloquial mentality. Or I need to be prescribed a thermography for the disease or whatever. I'm not insane. With our talon, you were saying it with confidence. You were saying it benevolently. You were saying it as if you even have the record. These are the people who have scattered your family at home. That's why you see some family today. Odiengbe, he's not agreeing with the senior son. These are you scattered everywhere. Why not turn the air outside down? I'm hearing of what is happening. Build it now. Build it yourself. I pray that man who I've labored, as you people choose to make sure his effort is thwarted. Because you people are bad head. You people are bad head. Nonsense. A nikompo, a charlatan, a misguided element. If you don't hurt. So I won't be able to deal with the objective of the International Association for the advancement of colored people, then let us take a close look at, I think I've been able to tell us, human being, they check action, why God judge you by the motive behind what you are doing. So let's try and imitate good things, let's know our purpose in life, so that we'll begin to judge people by the motive behind what they are doing, not by their action. I told us some time ago, when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. When you doesn't know the purpose, why you belong to, where you belong to, then you begin to abuse it. Instead of you to cause solution in between two that are making problem, what do you need to do? You support the one that raised the highest alarm. And that person may come tomorrow realizing that, I did the right thing in a very wrong manner. Then what you do is to clap and follow. That's why I'm better than some people, 100%. Because I've never one day judge anybody by the action. I always look at the motive. There was a time I said, no, this person did the right thing in the wrong manner. That's the best way. Even the person that's in Germany, whether that person was,
awa mu yon oga wi yon zage dem ni bodo. Almighty defended by, but when it come to another busybody in another person's issue. But that was not how I even related when we were having problem. Up till now, I go what oge, what platform. We might defend it, but you couldn't even defend yourself. But I will leave you people for God to judge. So help me God. So the reason for which something exists is purpose done or made, an intended or desired result, end, aim or goal. The purpose, why this platform has been set up, we have a purpose. That's why we have an aim we are aiming at. We have a result we are going to get, and we have a goal. What is some of our goal? The end analysis is the goal, which is we now have a society that is free and void of racial discrimination, that is free and void of segregation, that is free and void of misguided element. Those are some of the things. Please, the number I'm seeing here is not okay. Please, just invite your friend. He said, to feast, design outcome or idea that is he, object of an action or other effort, that which is relevant or under consideration. Another word for purpose is that which is relevant, or you can even put it under consideration. The purpose will be considered. These are the things that our leader they lack today. They doesn't know why they have been made president. Some member doesn't know why they were called a member. I have eyes that you have seen, have his purpose, nose have his purpose, mouth have his purpose. He performed a major function in the body. Without the mouth right now, I cannot talk. But inside that same mouth, you have some elemental factor that make it to function. The tongue is there. The teeth is there. Under the teeth, you have the incisors, you have the premolar, and you also have the molar. Then under that same mouth, if you view it down, you also have the gullet. All those things have their own functions. So what am I trying to tell us is this. We have to know our purpose and our efficiencies in life. That is why when you do not know the purpose why you come to this life, what you do? You cut menace in a society. All you now do, it will become ole fofo. You are always busybody in another person's issues. That is what you do. So it is our duty, very, very compulsory, to know our purpose in life. If you read the book of Ephesians, Paul the apostle knows his purpose. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 1. He said, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord beseech you that you walk in the vocation wherein ye are called. Walk in the purpose why you have been called. Walk in the purpose why you belong to the house of Senate. Walk in the purpose why you were made the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. That's why a son in a family knows his purpose. At the time, a father also knows his purpose. My own is to raise up my children. While later on, after I might have taken care of my children, in my old age, it is what you can give, what you can get. That's why some people today, they are enjoying their children. Why? Because they spend quality money. They give them, their children, a quality education. And in other words, education is the best legacy you can give to a child. That is some of your purpose. A good administration is what our leaders, both from the local level to the federal level, a good administration, that is the purpose they have been called to come and serve. You are not being made a legislator for yourself. No. That is not why you have been made a legislator. No. You are in that position to serve your people. That is why in diaspora here, if you win an election, does not mean you just get rich automatically. You still have a lot of work to do. You can become an ex-president in Spain here. You will still live an average life. If God is not taking a time to come, 20 years after your throne, after your retirement or whatever, you can still come back driving push and start if God is not taking. Because the looting system in Nigeria, you don't find here in diaspora. It is very, very rare. So if we find ourselves in such predicament, what do we need to do? We have not to struggle hard. Know your purpose in life. It is very, very important. Look at what the apostle said. He said, therefore, I, the prisoner of the Lord, know that Paul was in prison. Because Paul had been able to discover his purpose, he can no longer be going where he used to go before. That was why Paul the apostle called himself, I, the prisoner of the Lord. Paul was not in Oko prison. He was not in Guantanamo. No, where terrorists have been kept. No. Because so many things restricted his movement. Oh, if not before, this woman will cost me so. I for doing like this. That is what is happening to me right now. I can therefore say, writing letter to the Corinthians, I knew to the prisoner of the Lord, because there are so many things I would have done today in this show. Because I've been able to know my purpose in life is to edify soul, not to begin to lay curses that are going to damage people's destiny. I have to let go. It doesn't mean I'm not going to speak, but I have to bring it down. That's what Paul the apostle said. Paul, we are not in any prison. No. Because those things that Paul used to do, when Paul were killing Christians, he was thinking we were fulfilling the right purpose. No. But when it now come to a time, when the Spirit of God arrested him, Paul were going somewhere to go and so burn church before it was Saul. The Spirit of God arrested him. How? Even he tell you before, he hear things where, oh, or damn it, be. According to a musician in Benin, or when you eat tosisi, when you tag baby, you give a game more, you know, mosisi, you talk. It takes tag bad amu. It takes to no money, yari, and I so. Many are very many, but he give the whole year so. My master, God bless you. He a dog and I will know. I can't go back on your boy. I will leave you to your faith to see how you repent and cry unto God, God, I've heard against someone that you have chosen. He said, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. I am prophet of God, you should know by now. This cause is not an easy thing to fight. For those, as many people who are in this race with their real mind, ask them what they are passing through within. As many people who are in this race with their real mind, ask them, it is not an easy thing for you to begin to reveal the secret of the wicked. That's why the reason why pastor charge you most, because as they are dragging and get over to us on another day, when the witches and wizards, they are pressing them, that's why they charge most of you excess money, because they know it's not an easy. When the war comes, you are not going to be there. Also, it is in this fit of a bouquet. It's not an easy thing for you to start removing food from people, what they do eat before. You are now exposing them, particularly when you are doing it biblically. So be very, very careful over the kind of scandal that you run. It's going to get back to you. So I don't want anybody to lose his life as a result because of your bad mouth. Don't go and end your life. Nobody knows tomorrow. You can be the next person. That's why today, from Honorary Ketika, I know where I am right now. I know a lot of people may not be happy about the book of Genesis 37. When the children of Jacob and his brothers, then Reuben and the rest, they came to Egypt looking for food. There was a sense when Joseph told them, what you people meant for me for evil, God has turned to become good. You know the mission with them carried? They carried Ugbo. Alaska, we are there. Osayomore, we are there. Osula, we are there. They were playing. They were dancing. That's why, mind the way you worry people. Or that the heaviness you think you have right now, you are going to get more headache. Because I'm not going to be in that place. There is no way I can ever sleep with you inside the room again. If I'm traveling from here, my hotel reservation will first of all be sent to my phone. Ariel, I'm not going an inch. It's a promotion. Henceforth, I'm going to be addressed. As his excellency, whether you like it or not, whether local or international. Henceforth, I'm going to be addressed as a president, whether you like it or not. So you even have a time to sleep with a president in one room. All you do, it could lie. You see to it. If Joseph's brother know that selling Joseph, we make him to become a prime minister. Therefore, not selling. They regretted it. Why? Because what you are meant for me for evil, God turned it around to become good. You are the ones that are supposed to be crying, not me. I've looked at it, I don't lose anything. I didn't lose anything. You are the one. And who were here every day? Even you that soon. Who were so day? I will also say, sorry if you are, no. Who were you so day? You are going to get it up. Because there's no way I will ever come again to come and sleep in your house. Onigisunu. Before I left my base, hotel reservation, I will be picked from the airport with a private car or whatever. If at all, the position I am does not even warrant it. I will order for it myself. So you have to be very, very careful the way you worry people. That's why let anybody do what is in his mind. It's not to start worrying people. If not, the headache you further get, you will get more. That's what is going to happen. Because there's never a time you are going to see me the way you used to see me before again. The name you used to call me, you know, I do any. I'm above that name right now. Okay, who lose? So we should try and be very, very careful over the way we worry people. Look at, we have series of parables that our Benin Empire have laid down during the time of Oba Iwakpe. Now we all know about Oromi. What they meant for Oromi, Oromi today became one of the most beautiful birds you can think about. I think they call it a guinea fowl or whatever, I don't know. You should know. That's why I don't worry anybody. If I choose to worry you, I'm going to worry you to your blessing. So a time is going to come, I will call you guys, the two witches, women, female, and the other also, Azeni, which is Humphrey. I will call you where, the way Joseph celebrated, so who lose? So I'm talking about purpose. So if you doesn't know your purpose in life, then you begin to look at other people's that are trying to fulfill their own purpose. Everybody have a reason why they come to this life. Your reason may not be my own. There are a lot of people today now, what is their problem is not my problem. I've seen some people complain about, if I can speak the way you speak right now, how we say now maybe that guy. But what you are looking at is a problem to me. What is a problem to you is not a problem to me. He said, as our faces are different, so our heart desire is. As a woman or as a man, what do you need to do? Discover your purpose in life. Discover your purpose. What are you going to do? Uri agbona do toge. Aduri agbona do hi uno zarebu. So at the time you are able to get all the prerequisites in your mind, it will energize you to work harder to enable you what? Fulfill your dreams. If you read the book of Proverbs 19, verse 21, it says, many plans is in a man, is in a man's heart, but of the Lord we stand. Many plans is in a man's heart, but the will of God we stand. What is that will of God? Your purpose in life. That is why, for those people that doesn't know their purpose, they have time to talk about other people. Those are the people that backbite. They babble too much. They always concern. Making calls around you. See the one we talk today. Mind your business. If as close to 50, you haven't made an impact, apart from you just born children. Only God knows whether the book of Proverbs chapter 22 verses, train up a child. If you can lie like that, you have been lying from the senior to the second one. Why will you, a mature person that would have lived a exemplary life, you lie? How are you going to operate your children? How are you going to gather them together? So that what the senior one tells you, because you are getting favor from the last one, you will not go and be lying. No wonder the Bible says, by their fruits you shall know them. If you read the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 13, he says, for it is God who is at work in you, but of the will of God, and not for his good pleasure. And for a good pleasure. He said, for it is God's will that is at work in you, both of you, to work of his good work pleasure. For you to ascertain to a very good level in life. Don't be too concerned for others. Find your purpose. Right now, if you look at it, I don't imitate anybody. I don't imitate. I've never wanted to have personal problem with anybody rather than to defend and uphold what I believe on. I'll be standing at the defense. Say my matter. No, I have no time. I told people before, instead of me don't have anything, even though now one viewer I get, I came here to come and make it. It is not that far away. He said many are called, few are choosing. I want to have the few choosing one. A lot of people were in Galilee. A lot of people were in Jerusalem. A lot of people were in Judea. In all, Jesus Christ was only having 12 disciples. So why did I even care about thousands watching me online? At the end of the day, people are just there. I don't need that. If this 28 viewers I got today, me, I'm happy. I wait on my bed. I know that inside this 28, maybe one or two might have been, I've been able to impact one or two persons. That to say, after the show, a lot of people right now, they'll go to vomit for house. I never see this kind of thing before. So what we want to do that, as many people that come, there will be a testimony. Look at what God is using that guy to come and do. I have come to come and challenge a lot of people in social media that there is need why you must mind your damn business. I don't create topic on people to get viewers. If you look at most of my heading, it is God. I don't say, okay, now this one, why your man against here? Make I put this one. No. I don't believe in that. So at the time you have been immune to viewer, anytime there is no viewer online, you will get fainted. I've been in a church where pastor will be having seven members. He goes, shasha, at the end of the day. I'm also this one, so come on, so still come. You never see the 30. I think we all almost have been close to 40 just now. So that is it. It will go and it will come. There are people right now, if you just come in, hey, they're not the court there. Hey. This boy, where they do pastor, what may carry they go? They want to go where gossiping day. They want to go where those things that they are saying is not going to help them in any form. Let me see who's calling me, please. Yeah, I will be there. Hey, please, I dare on live broadcast. I'll call you back when I'm through. No. It was a different thing entirely. A story one. Let them watch it well. I will call you back. I will call you back. A story one again. The video is there. Go and watch it. That one is story. So let's try and do the needful. So if we are able to mind our business, life will be more easier for us to live. So that this quarreling in social media today, how we going to be able to stop it? Some of the reason how we can stop it is this. Some of the things we need to have back of our mind. Find the thing you can do best. Be doing it without putting any person to it. Because if you watch it right now, if for example our children go to YouTube, have you ever delivered a message that children will sit down and learn from? Okay, this program, let's watch it and learn from it. Let's ask ourselves this question. How many people that come to social media? And you cannot be doing something and that thing now have nothing to write home about. That thing have nothing to write home about. Some of the speech Martin Luther King made today, we want to listen to it because it was done well. Let us also think it. Anytime we are putting down, okay, if you watch it right now, even when I was trying to bring in some people, that's why I choose to reserve the other two names, because I want to see show to them that everybody has war, you know. But I'm trying to teach them, because it really why they must check motive instead of deliberating on the action. All those are teaching. So other people that want to also do the same thing tomorrow, what they will not do? Instead, this thing, that the way this person do, made mistake. Let me first of all confirm before I pass my judgment. So if we are saying anything, it is being duplicated. And anything we are saying right now, Is this what is going to make our work tomorrow, whether it's going to be effective or not? That is why tomorrow is going to come, not the result we are getting right now. When a lot of people will keep on checking your video, the reason why I get today, people say I'm doing my best because they go to my past video and play it. They go to my past video and play it. And at the time they play it, they find out that, what this guy is doing is really doing it well. That's why most of you are here today. Because what? You saw it before that what this guy said the other time, it makes sense. I benefited from it. But let me visit this page again. Why is people coming to come and watch you? Are they watching you because you entertain them? They are whiling away time or they are learning from you? It's a question we need to ask ourselves. And under that same distance, know your purpose in life. So it will be easier for you to deal with people. I know they I'm going to put in the head in there between Osama Bin Laden. No, I will not do it. If that is the only thing remains social media, me, I will resign because I pay normal. I will not resign because it is not a part of my life. I don't like it. And the people that do it, I pray that God will help them. Okay, what is viewer, for example? What is viewer? 1,000 are watching you at the end of the day. They are splitting nonsense about you outside. Tell me, what are you going to gain? He said, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world? What shall it profit you to get viewer? At the end of the day, if they go and check your works, they are all useless. That's why I said it day before yesterday, that social media, sanitization is coming to social media. And how are you going to be rewarded? It is due to your work that you are going to be rewarded. Let it not be that I was having the more bigger platform. Why is it not that I carry zero? You carry zero because of what? You were using your platform not to do the main purpose. Why it has been set up? That's why my platform right now has been set up for a divine purpose. And that purpose must be fulfilled. If you read the book of Acts 13, chapter 36, it says, for David, after he has served his own generation, he has served now. David has served his own generation. He has fulfilled what his purpose. By the will of God, fell on sleep and was laid on his fathers and saw what corruption. If you watch it today, what are you going to remember for? A good purpose and a good fight you have fought. If Martin Luther King did not fight a good fight of faith, nobody for remembering today. If we are remembering Osama Bin Laden right now, how will take the remembrance? How are we remembering Osama Bin Laden? How are we remembering Saddam Hussein? Let's think about it. Today now, with the name Buhari have lived right now, if he does not repair before even leaving, with the few more that remaining, how are we going to remember Buhari? So most of the time, you find out that we are the cause of our problem. We are the one that give us. Before you can tell me now, begin to call me liar when I don't lie. Nobody will come with a proof and begin to say, boy, not Tori. Nobody will believe you. At time, most of the time, we are the one that will wear that crown and be bad head. Why? Because you keep on doing one thing and you are expecting a different result. Let's discover our purpose. If you watch it today, I'm mainly talking to, I'm not talking to a leader. A lot of people will say, Buhari is not just the major, Buhari was in Ayanaji. Buhari is on social media. Whereby Bini, Oronigbe, and Oronigbe will be lying upon Oronigbe. Forgotten Olokun is there. If you can lie against your own brother from the same land, if you were to be somebody from Uromiunko, you go carry gun, kill him. I've come here to come and educate us. That's why a lot of people, they did not really attend school. It shows in them. You know, when you talk about stark illiterate, there are really people that they are born again illiterate. They are born again. The illiterate today is benevolent. Even Benin, they cannot even control it well to settle issue. I've seen people, but all we imagine is school, but Enwain. There is a sense why the Benin say, well, Enwain be Enwain Saloboa. The wisdom from above, look at Solomon. The richest king that has ever lived. He did not ask for riches. When he looked at it, that the palace was full with wives and concubines. God asked him, Solo, what will I do for you? He asked for only two things. God, give me wisdom and understanding. That's why I pray for from God. Seek ye first wisdom and understanding, and every other thing shall be added. At the time I'm able to build up my platform with wisdom and understanding, viewer will come. I don't need viewers that are charlatan, who believe on quarrelism, who believe on wookism. No, that's not the kind of viewer I need. I need viewers who I will impart. They will also go and impart other people. If you watch it today, Proverbs chapter 18, verse 16, he says, a man's own gift will make a way for him. He maketh him to sit among the men. If you are able to discover your purpose in life, it will make you to seek a more president. The reason why I was one of the number one top eminent personality in where I was because why? I know my purpose. I don't believe it, they say. Anytime there is attack, okay, so and so attack, huh? Look at the Bible verse I'm going to use in attacking. Instead of you to find your purpose, you were out there quarreling in the platform. That's why there's no way you can grow. There are people that you don't even know how to read and write. It does not really matter, say you know how to read and write or not. But the most important thing, where you are. A lot of people do ask me, bros, you don't grow for village. How now come you they speak Benin with this happening? I asked somebody one day, mature person about 40 years. When you are here, you don't know. Because all these things are what I know, I'll be applying it together. He says, study to show thyself approved. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. For you to divide the word of truth, try and know your purpose. It is very, very important. A man that knows his purpose, there are things that you will be saying. You will not say this one, I better level none. I will not find myself seeing laying course on the new generation, no. Because what? I've grown beyond that. That's why there was a sense when my father, my late father, blessed memory, and some of his friends, they said that Emila no ma sewe iwai nami uwobohwa oga rukpasia those days. Anytime we visit one of our friends, his father was a pastor. That is the language his father will always use for him, because why? He said, iron sharpeneth an iron, so a friend supposed to sharpeneth the countenance of his friend. That the friend that son we are supposed to be moving with was son of a pastor. Not them are fathers who go to a kidun. I never charge him for it. There was a sense why I say it. Then, if you want to furthermore explain it, you can become a miller, no man serve you, and I'm in Wobohuan due to what comes out of your mouth. Know your purpose. If you are able to discover your purpose, then you'll be able to guard yourself, not the mist where you are supposed to be. That's why we hear at times a lot of people, the way they talked about vagina, or talk about some other basic amenities that we use in reproduction. I better just die. They go just, they pull mark, they knock a blast, they pull left for a quarter. Patak, 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 patak. At times I'm ashamed of myself. Let's discover our purpose in life. If you know your purpose, it will guide you. I know my purpose as a leader. I know my purpose as a follower. I know my purpose as a bona fide member. If you are able to know all those things, you know that it is not every word that your leader called for. First of all, verify it. I have a brother from another mother. I will not, for security purpose, maybe if it is here, you know who I'm talking about. He does not just pick battle anyhow. During our discussion some time ago, he said, he's not the type that I met people beating my father, I will start fighting. I'm not a live boy to be. I know where Benin will always say it is a bad child that will go and be asking questions when they are beating his father. But most of the time, it's not like that. You did not even know whether your father used ritualism to collect other people's testes. You don't know what your father has done. There is a sense why you must get close and ask partially, please, what is happening? Or you can even ask for father, Baba Wosun. than to say you just start fighting. At the end of the day, you are still going to kneel down and beg. So it's of two options. It's of two options. That's why before you take any action, first of all, wait. As your father wants to report to you that these same people, they have been insulting me. The problem has already been on ground. That is to say, there is a sense why you must not have to ask, because a case I've already reported to you before that. These people, there was a day they came. They insulted me, I let go. If they come here again, I'm going to give them what they want. You have been pre-informed. But automatically, you see people who used to respect your father, and right now they are beating your father. You just put your chest and start fighting. At the end of the day, you also be the one that goes, imagine it, Baba Wagu, ya wone. Epa Wagu, where are you bomu of your hanekeru, ya you bomu en wen? Oh, monu wese no bie. Who want to consume that time? You fight a nonsense fight. That's why Bini have made down the parable. Try to explain it two ways. No, now, let me gradually again give us another definition. Bini Wolo make one parable say, when the going get tough, the tough men get going. Let me put it this way. I don't know how to speak, put it in English. I don't want to make mistake. I know a lot of Edo people are watching. Edo will come back here, you do guai. Queen Mary too, one of the biggest ships in the world, Edgar Yudugwa. At the time Queen Mary too had fought in the high sea, carry your shirt and go. Are you Duguani? So a lot of people, they will find themselves in a predicament of no return. They want to take it on persisting. I know I must look forward. No, I must get it because Edo Tane will come and Yudugwa. Etetani ke Edgar Yudugwa, Ale Foni. Ale Fe, carry rescue boat that is inside. Run. You don't need to go and kill yourself. So all parables you see today is of two definitions. Explain it to the way. I've made a series of lessons. That's why I wonder today. Somebody say, Vovo Euji, Arie Yihe, Ege, Ave Aori Ekwa, or the Ari Ege, Eomi. Eomi in my domain, I'm eloquent. By the grace of God. Then you could say that against me. Use needle to describe me. That proving you were. All what you have been saying right from time. You are. All of them, they are all fallacy. You are a liar from the pit of hell. Somebody like me. Where we memade relevant. If at all you want to criticize anybody, say the truth. So know that life is of two stages. A lot of people will say, I now bad son, go see say useless son, my dear, as a company now, that is when you have not matured. When we were those days, when we started doing Agbaka in the 80s, 90s, you know, they get time where Agbaka, they want the phone. Maybe after you don't go do some kind of worker, do all those slap and phone and the rest, you know, they just see the phone guy. But I know do a lot of people, they were very doing it. They'll go to fight, they go and all of that. Now that cannot be this time. If I meet you beating my younger sister right now, and I found out that you are about 40 years old and you are beating a sibling of 9 years as if it's your mate. He's not a running. I'm a very good teacher who explain everything. He's not a running. The way you will beat your own son, we have no problem. Anyway, because of 9 years old daughter, we have fear Ajalo. You will be marking Ajalo. That one may not be accepted. Who are they calling? Please hold on. Yeah, hello. Hello, good evening. Please, I'm on live Facebook. I'm on live Facebook. Who is talking to me, please? Huh? Hey, Chairman, what's up now? Hey. I did live Facebook. No, I didn't like Facebook. I didn't do live broadcast. I'll call you back if I true. I beg. I'll call you back. So those are the things. We should be able to understand so many things. This life has so many risks. It has so many tricks. If you doesn't follow it well. Because some of the things our forefathers have dropped down for us. If you use it without diluting it or purifying it by a chemical mist, you are going to get it hot. That's why for the people that do kankan, at times this vocal you see in store, they miss it again. For the people that do can, I think they say Urobo people also Urobo side, you know. If you drink, you say you want your drink and can, they haven't diluted, you're going to have problem. So if you want to keep on using all word, the way or by all work we use it, you may miss it along the line, but you have to use your wisdom. Wisdom from above. That's why today, a lot of people, a no game will just pass a law. Instead of the chiefs, instead of the followers to ask Enoge, we are not going to ban them. Nana, why are you saying we should ban all market women from coming to market next week? You just said that, hey, Enoge, I talk, but hey, he said. When you know that even your own wife at home have something supposed to carry to market, that if he doesn't sell it the next market day, he will lose thousands of euros. These are the problems that we are anywhere belief face. Let's try and use our wisdom. It is very, very obligated for us to know our purpose in life. Very, very obligated. We have to know our purpose in life. Very useful. Those are the things that are not negotiable. It's a must, we must do it. Please, if today is your first time of stopping by, don't hesitate to like this page and share this video. God bless you. Then if you read the book of Ephesians chapter 4 verse 26, it says, never give place to the devil. Neither you give place to devil to operate in your life. At the time you know your purpose, you know the area where you are supposed to go. A man that knows his purpose, choose and select friends he go out with. Because it is not every friend that is going to your direction. You have to discover your purpose. Why did I come to this life? Am I supposed to go and join armed robbery? Or am I supposed to go and join one secret cult that I will not be using human skull to be drinking blood? So if you know your purpose, it will shape you to choose the kind of mist you will be at a particular time. That's why that man, the reason why I keep on using that word was that these people, they doesn't know, the son did not know his purpose, that he was supposed to be a son of a pastor with a difference, who does not practice dagodalism, who will always stay and read his Bible. That's why his father was using that word, Emil anoma sevi wae na mewubo webohuan. And there is a sense in it. Why every one of us must use it, this very word, and caution ourselves by ourselves and see the best of where we can be able to live our lives. It is very, very important. Very, very important. Then if you also read the book of Proverbs 20 verse 7, he said, the just man walketh in his integrity. His children are blessed after. A just man, a man that knows his purpose, a man with a potential, walketh in his, he has integrity. If you don't want people to begin to use you as instrument of radical and caricature, don't use people as instrument of radical caricature. Don't use them. Don't you use them. Hold on to your integrity. If you look at Job, we are able to protect his own integrity. If we come to a time, his wife asked him, Job, why not curse God and die? He told his wife, say, naked I come and naked I will go. That's why there is a sense why Benin say, everyone needs to hold his own integrity. Did you got your integrity 10 years ago? You have to hold it up to now. No matter the situation, don't ever allow your integrity, because your integrity is what's going to make your children's life to shine. That's why today, anywhere you mention the name of Nelson Mandela, that you are able to bring a certificate of occupancy that you came from that family, anything you need, they will give it to you. Nelson Mandela. That's why anytime today, you may mention of Martin Luther King, because those were men who were able to hold their integrity. The reason why today we may mention of Abraham, because Abraham was able to hold on to his integrity. The reason why we may mention today Jehoshaphat, because those men were able to make mention of their integrity. The reason why today God so blessed that name Jesus, He says it's a name that is above to that is above every other name, because why? He was able to hold on to His integrity even at the cross. He says, "Father, forgive them, because they know what they were. They don't know what they are doing to me." Even we come to a time when even ask for water, they gave Him vinegar. But in all, He says, "Salobo ayabian." How many of us who have that mind that we say, "Ite tonsi simuti agbemi." He tell you, no man, he tell you, I'm a ni. He tell you, I'm a ni, but he even do it. You know what he say me, yeah. Some of all these things we are passing through today, most of all, we are problem to ourselves. Nobody's worrying us. That's why there is a sense why the Bible says, say, man is the architect of his own misfortune. Man is the architect of his own misfortune. And that is in the book of Genesis. Imagine, God kept Adam and Eve in the garden. I said, the reason why God kept Adam and Eve in the garden, there was a purpose why He kept them there. He said, dress it and keep it. Doloyi. But at the end of the day, what did they do there? Somebody that make you a caretaker of a building, he said, don't be paying house rent, take care of it. That's why there is a sense why many people will always say, Nehiwe eged bowa ogario wawuhu or yewekinyo. He does not know the purpose. He does not know the purpose of having the house. We have to be very, very careful over the way we do our things. Let's try our integrity. It is not the worst. Any work you do without integrity, they are going to see your children and start putting shade, 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 shade. Like the seed, most people right now, most young youth, they are showing social media. Quarrel here, quarrel here. Why not just come to this platform and come and learn? And say, okay, now, I want to emulate what this guy is doing. Whether I'm doing it well or not, there may be mistakes. There is no perfection in humanity. Even Jesus Christ did not even accept perfection. So there must be skipping some kind of things you hear here. But the most important thing, if you know your purpose, you should be able to know that, look at what this boy we're trying to say. Being that it was not a written manuscript, mistakes must come. Let know our purpose. Hand have a purpose. Cap have a purpose. The purpose I put on this cap right now, because I don't know Baba Bolo. I don't want people to be looking at me and say, this guy here be like Juju Memiri. So I have to cover it. So a lot of you will not be afraid. So everything has its purpose. What purpose of wristwatch? To check time. And it also beautify your dressing. What is the purpose of the human hair women are wearing today? Even Ghana, Indian, or whatever, or Brazilian human hair. It has a purpose. It brings out the beauty in a woman. What are the purpose of this makeup today? Because it covers up the spots that you have in your face. Everything has its own purpose. So you as a man right now, if material things have a purpose to serve, those things have been made to serve us. Then who are we made now to serve? We are not made now to serve our people. And how are we be serving our people? Are we be teaching the right word our people are supposed to hear, that we edify them? Or we have caused a lot of havoc rather than the good? Most of us, we have caused a lot of damages in social media. I'm also included. I will not tie this blame to anybody. Let us go home and ask ourselves. The harm that we have caused in social media is more bigger than the good we have done. Because the only area I would have said we have done well, if we now have hygiene and society. For example, all those who we swear at times they kill people, how many people remain today? All those BB courses we lay. Let us assume he really kills. And you know that he kills, that is why you are doing it. You know he kills, that's why you are doing it. Let's take a look. Is that our purpose, to come and use curses to finish God's own children? There's no way God will be happy with you. There is never a time. He said the power of life and death lies in power of our tongue. All those Ogun with this, all my enemy with this. Let's assume it happens. What is going to be your game? Let's assume all the curses we have been laying through Bible and all of all that. I'm a part of it. That's why I will not tag this one to anybody. We have caused many names, but we have come here to come and repair those things right now we are spoiled. How many people is going to join in this struggle? That even Mamuri and Madoloi. If I am a tier born and I never tell me I work a boy and it's one, he sell your way. The mount have been given to us for us to pronounce good things into people's life. If you believe that if I say this thing to this person, with confidence it's going to work. Also believe that if you prophesy unto a person, for good it will happen. So we have to leave the bad side and do the good one. Proverbs 20, verse 7. He said, the just man walketh in his integrity. A man that is just. And the Bible said, the just shall live by faith. A man that is just. A man that knows his purpose. That's why a lot of people right now, they rigmarole. Check the shoes you wear. At times, most of us right now, we'll go by high heel. Why? Because you want your height to be increased. That's why if you see some people right now, their height is not constant. If you see them, they are going to party, they will just talk. If you see them when they are coming back, right now they are not wearing slippers, they go low. Because look at it, that this place I'm going, this slippers will not work. I need to go and wear high heel, like 5 inches, 4 inches, and all of all that. Some people will even wear 6 inches. Because you are trying to conglomerate some certain atmosphere with your beauty. Why is women fitting eyelashes? Because they know that that eyelashes will also serve a purpose. That's why there is a sense why Bini say, you don't marry on a festive day. Because everybody's beautiful. All those things that make you to be beautiful, they are serving their purpose. Ask yourself. Imagine this cap right now, he's doing his purpose. Anki right now. This Anki is doing his purpose to clean away sweat. What is your purpose in life? Ask yourself. So everything that we have spoiled in social media, in whichever way we know that we can fix it, we have to also come and fix it. Well, including me, we have caused more harm. We have caused more damages. Because some of the video, if it is not being removed, your even our children, their friends will look at it and say, your dad was a stupid man. Bet you me. So that's why, let's go and search our video, the one that we know that it is not lawful. Because what we believe on, the children we are bearing right now, they are not going to believe in it. At the time your child now knows, well, telling somebody Ogun will kill you, that is to say that person may fall on top of plane or train track and go die, put. They go say, why will your father do such a thing? Why will your mother swear like this? You came from irresponsible family. So, some of the things we think we are doing right, we are doing it wrong. Total fallacy. So, let's know our purpose in life. It is very, 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 very important. Very, very. If you read the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 25, it says, therefore, putting away lying speaking, putting away lying, speaking every man the truth with his neighbor, for we are one member of another. The book of Ephesians. He said, wherefore, putting away lying, let live lying, or let every man speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are one member. We are one. Stop lying. Okay, for example, like what that woman said about me, I was crying and all of all that. If it were to be truth, maybe I was brought before the law court. Come and say what happened. You lie on me and I was jailed. How will you feel? Always put yourself in other people's position. If people do this thing to me, how will I feel? That's why I don't lie on people. Even though I know so many things about you, when we are quarreling, I don't use it against you. That's why there are so many. If I want to blow up the cyberspace with my talks, I can blow it up. I can do it. I want to blow up the cyberspace. I can do it. But as a matured man who has been able to discover his purpose, and with a very great potential, there are things I will never utter from my mouth. That's why, have you ever wondered, no matter how butai I may am, I don't use that word yelekute. I don't use it. Because if you stretch one finger on other people, the remaining four is pointing at you. So we are here to correct ourselves. We want equality, no intimidation, no segregation, no humiliation. So that everybody will find themselves. Even at this platform right now, you want to come and broadcast, you are very free. I find it does not mean that I'm going to be here all along. I can hand over it tomorrow, brother, take on. If my name wants to be written there, permit the constitution that you were one of the president, no problem. The most important thing is that what we are going to achieve It is the mind of every good leader. What am I going to achieve after my administration? Have I going to be charged for genocide in the international law court? Or I'm going to be charged that, you are one of the great leaders we have ever seen. What are you going to be remembered for? Today, we talk about the first of Obaiware, because he done well. During that the time of that Oba, His Royal Majesty, everything were very good. What you are seeing today, this very new administration, it won't first happen. I'm here today now buttressing the image of my father to you all. Mr. Imadeyu Nuagbon, Andrew Igbinigun, from Uduhueme family in Edu Canyon. My father was known as Oviomansi. I have to continue that name. Oviomansi. Anywhere I go, he talked like his father. Now, whom are we buttressing? Let's live down good name. Let's discover our purpose in life. You are surprised today, and I'm not more talking. It's not every time about Buhari. Buhari is not the one that has given you purpose. When did Buhari came? The Nigeria you are seeing today that now became in a precarious position. It don't spoil a long time ago for inside body. Nigeria don't rot in, and now it smell the common. So all this administration, it has been cooking right from time. A Rome was not built in a day. The collapse of Nigeria did not just start in Buhari's regime. It started during the time of... It started in the 80s right from time. Because why? There were no vision. He said, where there is no vision, the people there, they perish. So a country that has no vision, what did you expect? You must see all this kind of a thing. So let us all work. If we are able right now, if we want to be talking to the government from here, government is going to be afraid of this platform. Be you Kogi State government, be you Lagos State government, be you from Katsina, be you from Yombe, be you from Makurdi, be you from Burundi, be you from Niamey, be you from Madagascar, be you from Nasarawa, be you from Cotonou, be you from Benin, be you from Cote d'Ivoire. You are going to be afraid of this very platform. Do you know why? Because the way this platform is going to be structured, anytime we even mention your name, you will shake. Because people is going to emerge who want where in our society. That's why everybody's welcome here. Everybody, you are welcome. Because Abaco, let me borrow that word. I don't like using the verse I used the other time, use it here. Because Abaco chapter 2 verse, we say that the vision will make it plain. So the vision will be written. It's open for everybody. If you are a lawyer, come. For us to feast our community, these people, we must be charging some of them. Insulting them, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. We are going to do whatever thing we are doing in a diplomatic process. Mr. Governor, why was this money, this road not tied during your time? At the time, we are able to link ourselves to Amnesty International, link it up to UN. God will always make a way where there seems to be no way. Every good thing you see today always have a little beginning. That's why there is a sense why they say a Rome was not built in a day. It all depends if you are able to know the purpose of what you are doing. So many governments will through this platform and go to jail. They will go to jail. They will face the law. So far, we are able to present the necessary document. Look at right now, we are fighting for people. Why will our people be treated like this? Just the way Buhari were invited to the international court for genocide. It was people that set up all this UN you are seeing. It was some group of people that set it up. World Health Organization, it was a group of people that set it up. OAU, Organization of Africa Unity, that now became AU, Africa Union. It was people that started it. ECOWAS, Economic Community of West Africa State, ECOMOG, name it. It was people that started these people. The same spermatozoa that was released into your mother's womb, that was the same way their father released a spermatozoa into their mother's womb, but they survived and they became who they are. That's why I prefer to be in a place we are celebrated, not a place where I'm tolerated. There is a reason why anybody disconnects himself. If you want to know, do not check the action. Look for the motive. At times, the back of the note does not describe the content of the notebook. No. The notebook may be as flat as any other thing. It may not be painted as gold, but the content inside, if you read it and meditate on it, you'll become great in life. A word is enough for the wise. We must be very, very careful. The way you structure out your things. You see some people right now, what we're doing is we're doing well. A lot of people, you open up, maybe drop your water supermarket. Before you know, they'll say, this one don't take land. Because he discovered that this pure water, let me take it, is my purpose. I'm good in selling. Why the other one that is sister? Most of all today, the millions of nairas we give to our younger one to open business. The people that have the most highest supermarket today in Nigeria, they started with 5,000 naira. As at this very time, you gave your sister or your brother 1 million naira. Go and check because he does not know his purpose. He said, when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. When purpose is not known, when purpose is not known, where do they go? When purpose is not known, where do they go? When purpose is not known, you will become a Ayurvedic syndrome. A lot of people have been immune to these characteristics. After all, he go send another one. For those of us that came to Europe newly, we know the good, the usefulness of a document. What do we need to do first and foremost? We try hard to make sure we are able to acquire that document. Today, I figure the shot now, police go come and go knock at the door. Hey, Chava, I say, espera. U.S. Hacienda no cosa. 5 minutes, I need to wait. Cannot break the door. Because why? I have a document. You see some people, when they come, they go smoke Igbo tire. Half, oh, Bob, this one be like Kuala Igbo. Discover your purpose. There are more we can do than what we are doing right now. How come in this 10th, 21st century, you still belong to a group where you cannot really explain what you guys are doing there? Let's try our best. I'm urging everyone. Let every youth know that. If we know our purpose, to talk to the government will be very easy. If you know our purpose, if everybody in diaspora right now, okay, so and so time, if you can come right now, have a platform. Let everybody who wish well for our community, let's go to Nigeria so and so time. Maybe by the grace of God, I got some members who were assisting ticket. We go to the government house, Obaseki, for example, or Okorocha. Why are you people so wicked? When they've already know that, even to the organization we belong here, how we are able to affiliate all various organizations or movement, they send also spectators along with us. They will answer. They must answer you. So if we must change our community, it must be through a democratic process. If you want me to change, you keep on insulting me, I will not change. There are people that are very stubborn. But if you tell them, please, brother, I beg. I need this thing. Please, help me. It will help you. Look at it, 2 words. Daddy, give me money. I want to pay school fees tomorrow. You just look at it. But what are your money? What is it? But if you meet him, good morning, Dad. Please, that money I told you the other time, that my lovely daddy, I think you promised me today, Dad, he go give unto you. He go give unto you. So there are children. That's what the Bible says in the book of Proverbs 22, verse 6. It says, train up a child. If you nurture your child on how to ask a thing from his father, most of all right now, if our children don't they misbehave, if we dare ask and now we correct our children. There was a day I was in the church. One guy slapped his son. Kai. The way I take vibrate for him. He himself no say, I be one woes and back. Now this child, they do this thing. He started it long time ago. You want to prove now, so you'll be disciplined, man. Why there are some children, only with the look of the eye, maybe they won't give up with your looking like this. Jesus, Abo. Only that name, will say, Daddy, he will follow you. That's why the Bible says, He said, my sheep hear my voice. My sheep know me and they hear my voice. How have you been able to brought up your son? Do you brought them through jagodalism? Any small thing, slap, bo. You the lamb bossing for where your son dey. You the lamb bossing. My tassing. But you know if you beat your mate outside. Learn our purpose in life. This hand is not made to be beating your children. This mat is not made to be laying curse. It is made to heal the nation. To pronounce a word. And look at what the word of God. He said, my word will not come back to me void. Without accomplishing the purpose that is being spoken for. There is never a time the word of God will come back to you void. Never a time. Never a time. He must fall on the ground. If he has promised you, he must be expecting it, he must do it. Then let me quickly give us some of the criteria. I want to give us the purpose why the Bible were made, were written. The purpose why life were given to us. The purpose where the Bible were made. To relate human experience as a warning. The purpose of the Bible. Share this video among your friends. God is speaking to some people right now. The purpose. What some of the reasons. What the purpose why Bible were made. To relate human experience as a warning. To give knowledge of eternal life. Some of the reasons why the Bible were written down. One, to relate human experience as a warning. Human experience as a warning. Listen very carefully. To give knowledge of eternal life. Then another purpose where the Bible were made or written is to give hope to man. And to authenticate the divinity of Christ. To authenticate so that you read and understand how Christ suffered and how he was. That was the reason why the Bible, the purpose why the Bible were made down, were written. After this very point in time, let's go and ask ourselves, what is really my purpose in life? Then, the purpose of life. Let me also tell us the purpose of life. Doing the will of the Father. The reason why God gave you life is to do the will of the Father. The reason why God gave you life. The purpose why God gave you life. To do the will of the Father. Then, another purpose why Bible were written. It is profitable for instruction. Bible is profitable for instruction. Our president will be elected to give us a good administration. Give up basic amenities. Give us road. Give us life. Give us good health. Give us free education. If the money is there. Then another purpose again. Why the Bible were written or were given to us. To give hope to men. Is to what? To give hope to men. Then another word again, to give knowledge of eternal life. The Bible has been written to give knowledge to eternal life. And it also contains the message to be delivered. The Bible contains a message that every one of us should deliver. How are we going to deliver it? By our mouth. That's how we are supposed to deliver it. Then another thing again the Bible does, another purpose it says, is this. The study for encouragement. That's why when you begin to see that your enemy, they have traveled upon your life. You want encouragement from God. You can just say, okay, God, look at what you said in Exodus chapter 14, verse 14. That you will fight for me and I will hold my peace. It's an encouragement. Encouragement. The Bible has been written to give us encouragement. To authenticate the divinity of Christ. Then finishing the divine task. Another purpose why God has given us life is finishing the divine task. The purpose why God gave you life. There's a divine task. Preach the word to the people. He said, heal the sick, raise the dead. He also has even sent us, he said, up to Judea, to Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the world. We have to promulgate what? The word of God. Absolutely trustworthy. Another purpose of life is absolutely trustworthy. Are you trustworthy in your thought? Completing the course joyfully. We have to complete the course joyfully. The course that God has given to us in liberating people. We have to complete it joyfully. Without grudginess. Without hatred. That is how we are supposed to do it. Then the reason why again God gave us life. Is this the purpose of life? Imagine God breathed a Zoe life into us. In the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 26, after God might have made us in his own image after his likeness, he breathed his Zoe life into us. He breathed it to us. That's why the Bible says we were made in his own image and after his likeness. He breathed his Zoe life. Into us. That's why Jesus Christ said, greater thing you are going to do than what I've done right now. If the gospel of Jesus Christ ends in Samaria, we are supposed to go up to Judea and to the uttermost part of the world. That is why right now, if you see the way I choose to coagulate the word of God with my advocacy, I choose to do it with a different because I have my own purpose to fulfill as far as this life is concerned. Seeking God's kingdom. Another purpose why God gave us life is to also seek what? God's kingdom. We seek for it. We ask for it. How are you going to seek for it? There exists a way. He said, without holiness, no man can see God. Without holiness, no man. If you want to see God, there is a verse of the Bible you need to read. If you want to make it here on earth, there is also a scriptural verses you will read. Everything in life has its own principles. If you want to be poor, it has its own principle. If you want your children not to excel, it has its own principle. Anytime you see that good things are coming in the way of other people's children, spiritual realm. You go to Ogumagala. You go and consult Oracle. Also, your own have nowhere going. He said, whatsoever a man soweth, thou he shall reap. If we want our children to be great, let's try to see the same eye we use in looking at our children. Your uncle or your friend, tell his children to come and visit, come and stay with your children during their holidays. You give your children 3 square meals a day. But that one they left with you, give them 1 square meal. Then you want your children to excel. You are supposed to even take care of the children of your friend more than the way you take care of your children. Because so that as you are sowing that good seed, anywhere your children will go tomorrow, people will also leave their children and take care of your children. Say, whatsoever a man soweth, thou he shall reap. Purpose. Then lastly, attaining Christ-likeness. If you are very close to the Bible, this was Jesus Christ, Christ-like, or Christ. It was even the sinners who called Jesus. Yeah, hello. Okay, no problem. So those are the things. Christ, attaining Christ likeness. We begin now to do things like Jesus Christ. Look at what the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 5. He said, let this mind be in you. Christ likeness. That was also in Christ Jesus. It is a laid down principle that God Almighty have given to us. Let's follow it like that. Another purpose why God gave us life. God does not give you life to come and serve yourself alone. He gave you life to attain Christ-likeness. Do things like Christ. You want to rule a country. Rule it the way Jesus Christ was able to rule his people. Why left 99 sheep looking for one? Don't be judgmental. Don't be sentimental. Don't believe in favoritism in your administration. What happened to A, do it to B. If there's money in the, you are going to give allocation. Don't say Orion 1 will be bigger than one. Make it equal according to the habitat that are there. If you want to revisit the budget, you want to uplift it. Don't say because Orion 1 is APC and one is PDP, I need to go and give to Orion 1 because they are APC, they are my party members. To attain Christ-likeness. That's the reason why God has given you life. If they have not given you life, that's the purpose why God has given you life. So everything under the earth, there is a season and time for everything. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1. And purpose under everything, on everything under the earth. So please, don't fail to like this page. We are rounding up right now by the grace of God. It's very nice talking to every one of you today. God bless you. Please, for those of you who have come here to come and cause encouragement, you can do far better than that. Share our video. Our video, by the grace of God, God is going to give us empowerment. Our video is going to heal the nation. So this platform have not been created for intimidation. It have not been created for fiber. So rather than, we allow what God, the promises that God have given to us in the book of Exodus chapter 14 verse 14, that I will fight your fight and you will hold your peace. God blesses and every one of you in the mighty name of Jesus. See you some other time. By the grace of God, if I come up again, I'm going to be fixing a date, schedule a date, I'm going to be coming up. For those of you, thank you for your personage and God bless you in Jesus' name. Please, for more broadcasts, more powerful than this, just like our page and share our video. Follow more better when you go to come. You say we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. This is advocacy for a divine change. Advocacy that goes to heal our nation. Advocacy that goes to bring a divine change to our society. Thank you and God bless you.
Oh, Sagiriya, we move on Sagiriya. Oh, Sagiriya, we.
He was some man, me amigo, yes. He was free of charge, never collected money.
He was Sagiriya, me marambo.
Mama Santa. God bless you, God bless you. See you some other time. Remain blessed. And don't let's forget to tune in anytime we are online. Thank you and God bless you. Ciao.